have 7 days of racing here, starting today. And the goals for all racers are to break records out of our rule book. All of our classes consist of production cars as well as home-built race cars and backyard mechanics. Since 1949, SCTA has been here on the Salt, and we've had many vehicles over 400 miles an hour break records here. This type of racing is a 100% amateur organization. We're all volunteers to put this thing on, and what I mean by amateurs is nobody is a professional. Nobody's being paid to drive. No vehicles are sponsored with lots of money to help support their habit.
Everybody, come on, let's go. We gotta get wheels on a racetrack and kick some salt. And it's a big time deal for motorsports in general.
Well, I'm racing two cars out here, and I'm hoping to get 6 records with the two cars. My son's gonna be driving, and I'm gonna be driving. I got in the 200 mile an hour club when I was 17, thanks to my dad. And I've been racing ever since, and now my kids are racing.
It took me 41 years to get this red hat, whereas a lot of other people come up here and do it, zip, zip, and that's it. It wasn't so easy for me. Something not everybody can do, but those that do it and love it, it's a passion for us. It's a lifestyle for us.
Like Bonneville has been my vacation all my life. And my kids grew up here. This is vacation. This is all I know as far as hobby. And I've always, and this has just been my life.
One of the things I love about the Salt Flats and our landspeed racing is the multiple generations of families that race here. I've been coming for such a long period of time, I'm into my fourth generation in some families. My dad was a racer, that's kind of how I got involved.
Bonneville is like a family reunion. These are not cousins, really cousins, although I have a cousin out here. And, you know, I meet these guys once a year, and it's like a family reunion. This whole premise, everybody is friendly. You know, there's no egos, it's equal. Nobody is above anybody else. Because they're a racer, you're a racer. And there's no money here. It's just strictly for fun, and you may get a trophy.
So the salt out here goes through annual and seasonal cycles where it dissolves and then grows and dissolves and then grows in response to changes in the amount of rain and standing water and temperature driving that evaporation. So typically in the fall you get a lot of rain, and actually from about November till May there's a lake out here with standing water. You get dissolution of salt. But then through the spring and summer, if it's nice and dry, that water evaporates and you're left with this nice salt crust that sort of repaves every winter through that flooding, evaporation, and desiccation process.
In the wintertime, it fills up with water, so we wait for Mother Nature to finish her process. We really don't know anything till we get here. And when we get here, we figure out where we can race, how many courses we can put down, and do the best we can. Then, once that happens, we come up and start dragging as soon as the salt gets dry. And we come up 2, 3, 4 times, whatever it takes to make smooth surface.
There's a good extent of salt this year. There's, you know, a nice solid surface. We've been out here in the past where you're seeing what's underneath this uppermost halite crust. What the racers value and need to do what they're doing today is this uppermost, fairly thin halite crust, sodium chloride, which is actually really soluble. So a little bit of rain onto that surface, it dissolves. You know, you can imagine if you pour a little pile of table salt and pour water onto it, you'll dissolve that salt. The same thing can happen out here. When you get too much rain on the surface, not enough high temperatures and evaporation, you can actually dissolve this uppermost surface. The Bonneville Salt Flats is part of a much larger playa system that actually is cut right by I-80. And so to the south of I-80, the potash mine, where they've actually been evaporating groundwaters from this system to produce economic commodities, potash specifically, that's actually potassium that's then sold and used for agricultural fertilizers globally. And this has been going on for almost 100 years. The mine hosts a salt crust thickness study every 15 years, and this has gone on really since the mid-century. So from the surface, we can look and see the aerial footprint or extent of the surface salt, but that doesn't tell us how thick it is into the subsurface or the volume of salt. The last time it was measured was in 2003, and so it's been 15 years, and we'll come in and we will actually be doing this next month. In September, we'll be coring 70 spots across the salt crust and collaborating with the potash mine and with the BLM to make these measurements and compare it to past studies so that we can really see, has the volume of salt changed over time?
This year, the salt is pretty good. It's not the best we've ever had, but it's not the worst we've ever had.
We're feeling great about the good salt this year and getting folks back out here land speed racing like they've done for decades, and we hope for decades more. This kind of salt is what we need to see those fast speeds out here and everyone having a good time.
BLM's really excited about future partnerships with both the racing community and the Intrepid Potash Mine in researching the Bonneville Salt Flats and finding out more about the salt flats itself.
We all want the salt flats to remain a viable option for us to run our race vehicles, and we just hope that everything can work out fine and we can keep coming back here. Our only limitation really is Mother Nature. When there's rain here, we can't run. I've always said, if you want to run here every year, put it inside a building. But that'd be a pretty big building.